The right against exploitation is a very important component of socialism, and we find the expression in Article 39 F of the Constitution, where the states are mandated to direct their policy towards securing certain goals. And one such principle is that children are given opportunities and facilities to develop in a healthy manner and in conditions of freedom and dignity, and that childhood and youth are protected against exploitation and against moral and material abandonment. Article 23 is a fundamental right which states, traffic in human beings, beggar and other similar forms of forced labor are prohibited, and any contravention of this provision shall be an offense punishable in accordance with law. Article 24 provides, no child below the age of 14 years shall be employed to work in any factory or mine or engaged in any other hazardous employment. The two articles can be grouped under the rights against exploitation. This article contains three forms of exploitations, that is, prohibition of traffic in human beings, beggar profession, and thirdly, of other similar forced labor. Practice of any such form is punishable in accordance with law. The prohibition contained in Article 23 have made criminal acts punishable under some legislations in India. It will be appropriate to refer to some penal provisions under certain laws in force in India. In the Indian Penal Code 1860, which contains a provision under Section 370, that is, buying or disposing of any person as a slave is made punishable for imprisonment for a term which may extend up to 7 years and shall also be liable to fine. This Section 370 has been amended by the Criminal Law Amendment Act with effect from 3rd of February 2013. The heading of the section has been substituted as trafficking of persons. Under the existing provision, the offense of trafficking is defined. It has been defined that whoever, for the purpose of exploitation, recruits, transports, harbors, transfers, or receives a person or persons by, firstly, using threats, or secondly, using force or any other forms of coercion, or thirdly, by abduction, or fourthly, by practicing fraud or deception, or fifthly, by abuse of power, or sixthly, by inducement, including the giving or receiving of payments or benefits, in order to achieve the consent of any person having control over the person recruited, transported, harbored, transferred, or received, and such act will be punished in accordance with law. Under Section 370 of the Indian Penal Code, this section further explains the term exploitation, which shall include any act of physical exploitation or any form of sexual exploitation, slavery, or practices similar to servitude or the forced removal of organs. It is further clarified that the consent of the victim is immaterial in determination of the offense of trafficking. The offense of trafficking of person is punishable with the imprisonment of not less than 7 years, but may extend to 10 years and with fine. And if the trafficking is more than one person, the punishment is for imprisonment of not less than 10 years. It may extend to imprisonment for life and with fine. In case of trafficking of a minor, the punishment prescribed is for imprisonment of not less than 10 years and may extend to imprisonment for life and with fine. Under Section 370 capital A of the Indian Penal Code, exploitation of a trafficked person is punished for imprisonment of not less than 3 years and may extend to 5 years and with fine. But if the case is an exploitation of a trafficked child, the imprisonment provided is not less than 5 years and may extend to 7 years and with fine. There have been numerous cases of habitual dealing in slaves. Section 371 provides whoever habitually imports, exports, removes, buys, sells, or deals in slaves shall be punished with imprisonment for life or with imprisonment of either description for a term not exceeding 10 years and shall also be liable to fine. Under sections 372 and 373, selling and buying of minor for the purposes of prostitution or illicit intercourse with any person, that such person shall at any age be employed for the purpose of prostitution, shall be punished with imprisonment which may extend to 10 years and also be liable to fine. And under Section 374 of the Indian Penal Code, if any person unlawfully compels any person to labor against the will of the person, is said to commit the offense of unlawful compulsory labor and shall be liable to punishment with imprisonment for a term which may extend to 1 year, or with fine, or with both. There are specific legislations that are existing regarding immoral trafficking in women and girls, and regarding bonded labor. The Suppression of Immoral Traffic in Women and Girls Act 1956 is a legislation enacted for the suppression of immoral trafficking in women and girls. The penal provisions in relation to the act may be enumerated as keeping a brothel or allowing premises to be used as a brothel, living on the earnings of prostitution, procuring, inducing, or taking woman or girl for the sake of prostitution, detaining a woman or girl in the premises where prostitution is carried on, prostitution in or in the vicinity of the public place, seducing or soliciting for the purposes of prostitution, and seduction of a woman or girl in custody. To prohibit the making of agreements to pledge the labor of children and employment of children whose labor has been pledged, the Children Pledging of Labor Act 1933 was passed. Penalties are provided for parents or guardians making agreement to pledge the labor of a child, and penalty is also provided for a person making agreement with a parent or guardian to pledge the labor of a child. Further, penalty is also provided for employing a child whose labor has been pledged. It is to be noted that the prohibition imposed by this article is absolute and does not admit of any exception for employment of a child in a factory, mine, or in any other hazardous employment. The Factories Act 1948 is a pre-constitutional law and is still in force. Section 67 of the said Act provides that no child who has not completed his 14th year shall be required or allowed to work in any factory. A glance at the constitutional provisions will reveal that there are certain provisions which direct to the welfare of the children. In the first place, when the Constitution was originally enacted, provision was made for the children in the directive principles of state policy at Article 45. And since 2002, Article 21, capital A, has been added, guaranteeing right to education as fundamental right, directing the states to provide free and compulsory education for all the children up to their 14th year of age. After the coming into force of the Constitution, where right against exploitation was enumerated in the list of the fundamental rights, numerous legislations have been passed to prevent child labor in hazardous employments. As on today, many legislations are in force prohibiting employment of child laborers in different occupations. And to mention some of the legislations are Section 24 of the Plantation Labor Act 1951 provides no child who has not completed his 12th year shall be required or allowed to work in any plantation. Section 109 of the Merchant Shipping Act 1951 provides no person under 15 years of age shall be engaged or carried to sea to work in any capacity in any ship except in a school ship or training ship in accordance with the prescribed conditions or in a ship in which all persons employed are members of one family or in a home trade ship of not less than 200 tons gross or where such person is to be employed on nominal wages and will be in charge of the father or other near male relative. Section 45 of the Mines Act 1952 provides no child shall be employed in any mine, nor shall any child be allowed to be present in any part of the mine which is below ground or in any open cast working in which any mining operation is being carried on. Section 21 of the Motor Transport Workers Act 1961 provides no child shall be required or allowed to work in any capacity in any motor transport undertaking. Section 3 of the Apprentices Act 1961 provides a person shall not be qualified for being engaged as an apprentice to undergo apprenticeship training in any designated trade. If he is not less than 14 years of age and satisfied with such standards of education and physical fitness as may be prescribed. Section 24 of Biri and Sugar Workers Conditions of Employment Act 1996 provides prohibition of employment of children. That is, no child shall be required or allowed to work in any industrial premises. Right against exploitation is in fact an adjunct to the guarantee of right to personal liberty and prohibition against discrimination. Article 23 applies to all, irrespective of religion, race, caste, or class, or any of them, whether a child or an adult, regarding trafficking, beggar, and other similar forms of forced labor. But special protection provision is made for children below 14 years of age in Article 24. Innumerable legislations are also being made to give effect to these provisions. The Supreme Court's judicial activism is also seen in this regard, where the Supreme Court has given further directions as to education, health, and nutrition of the children. It is equally important to note that what is prohibited is child labor in hazardous employments. To take care of the right against exploitation and prohibition of child labor, equally important adjunct is right to education of the children of the age group from 6 to 14 years, which is now a fundamental right guaranteed to these children.